Good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Praveen Kumar, working as Junior Scientific Officer in the National Center of Organic Farming, Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India. As you all aware about the waste decomposer is a multipotent organic input, proving its miraculous thing with the farmers and as well as all the stakeholders of organic farming. Now, today I would like to tell you regarding the isolation of Azotobacter bacteria from the waste decomposer solution. So you all know, we are aware that there is bottle of one waste decomposer. If we take a single bottle of that, we can multiply it using jaggery. 2 kg of jaggery will be added to, is added to 200 liter of water, and after the solution is prepared, the contents of the waste decomposer bottle are added to the solution, jaggery solution. Then it is stirred twice a day in the morning or evening for 1 or 2 minutes, and it is covered with a cardboard or a gunny bag, whatever it. At any temperature it can be prepared, either in the shade or in the open field, anywhere. So once, within 3 to 4 days or 5 days, it depends upon the temperature and climate and the region, so the solution will be prepared. The solution, you can see that we have prepared in the open field condition, but for the isolation of Azotobacter, we have brought the waste decomposer solution in a conical flask. Now you can see the color of that, it is light cream in color and it is very turbid, and we are going to isolate this Azotobacter from the waste decomposer solution. So because most of the people, they have a lot of doubts, and as well as they have aspects are not clear about the mode of action and all. So today we want to clear that how we can prove that what are the organisms that are present and how we are going to isolate the Azotobacter. So many organisms are there, the nitrogen fixing, phosphate solubilizing, as well as other organisms which solubilize zinc and potassium. But now we are concentrating because our director, Dr. Krishan Chandra, who is the pioneer, is the person who has isolated this strain and developed this strain. Total credit goes to him. So our colleagues also made some videos regarding the isolation of the PSB and as well as rhizobium, etc. So in the same manner, now I would like to isolate the Azotobacter. Now I would like to show regarding the isolation of the Azotobacter from the waste decomposer solution. So most of you might know that we are working in the laminar airflow cabinet. So we have the waste decomposer solution, and we have the plates we have prepared for the culturing and isolation of these organisms, and we have some test tubes for preparation of aliquots, preparation of serial, this is the serial dilution technique. We have mentioned here 10 to the power of minus 1 and 10 to the power of minus 2, like this. So we will take the from the stock culture, we make the serial dilution of the stock culture, and then we will take and add the dilutions, the aliquots, to the corresponding plates. We have labeled it as 10 to the power of minus 1 and another plate 10 to the power of minus 2. Here we have 10 to the power of minus 2 and 10. So same correspondingly we have to inoculate that. So we will go for inoculation, right? Because we are going to do simultaneously in Telugu and as well as in English. So first we have two plates of each dilution, for each dilution. So one plate for English version and one plate for Telugu, inner plate. So culture, waste decomposer culture we are taking. We have taken 1 ml of culture. We are adding it to the 10 to the power of minus 1. Now, in the serial dilution technique, from the 10 to the power of minus 1 dilution, we pipette out 1 ml of the solution and we add this to 10 to the power of minus 2 dilution. You can see putting out the 1 ml from the 10 to the power of minus 2 dilution. Adding it to 10 to the power of minus 3 dilution. Mixing it using the pipette. Putting out 1 ml from the 10 to the power of minus 3 dilution. And adding it to 10 to the power of minus 4 to the power of, this is minus 5 dilution. And 10 to the power of minus 5 dilution. From 10 to the power of minus 5 we have liquid it out 1 ml. Now we are adding it to 10 to the power of minus 6. Similarly, we will add to the 10 to the power of minus 7, and from 10 to the power of minus 7, we will add to 10 to the power of minus 8. The final dilution. And from the final dilution, we need to pipette out 1 ml and it need to be discarded in order to maintain the quantity, the initial quantity, that was 9 ml. So we are discarding the pipette also, right? Just now we have made the serial dilutions of the stock culture with pure waste decomposer culture. Now this is the 10 to the power of minus 1 dilution. Now we are taking an inoculum of 0.2 ml and we will be adding to the corresponding plate, that is 10 to the power of minus 1. So today we are doing that, so that's why that date is mentioned. Now let us inoculate from the 10 to the power of minus 1 to the corresponding plate. So we have the we are working in a sterile environment created by the laminar airflow. Now you can see here distribute the culture evenly. So now 10 to the power of minus 1 plate we have inoculated, right? Similarly, we go for the inoculation of 10 to the power of minus 2.
the number of minus 2 dilution. Time for to inoculate the 10 to the power of minus 5 dilution. Now we have completed the dilutions, all the dilutions. Now this is for a Telugu version. Another net is left, that is pure waste decomposer culture. For that also, we take 0.2 ml of waste decomposer. Pure culture and vegetable culture. the dilutions in the corresponding plates and as well as the pure culture also in the corresponding plate. Now we will inoculate them in the incubator for 2 to 3 days, and we will observe the pollinates that are produced from the inoculum. Right?
My dear friends, as Dr. Praveen has tested the SR waste decomposer to know whether any Azotobacter bacteria, that is nitrofixing bacteria, is present inside or not. So what we have done, we have taken this culture and multiplied in the liquid. After multiplication of 7 days, now it looks like this. From this solution, we are going to test whether this contains the Azotobacter or not. Dr. Praveen has tested it and it has found this 1 ml of our solution contains crores of Azotobacter bacteria. So how it looks, that I want to first show you. You can see the food plates, and this type of plates are plated, and after 8 days how it looks, let's have a close look. Now you can see these plates, it is written there 10^6, and if you see 1 ml we have put inside. Now small dots, white dots, is all are full of bacteria. It is present in crores. And the characteristics of Azotobacter bacteria, I will show you. It make a pigment. It gives the color. You can see the color. Light brownish color is there. So this all colonies are turning in the color. So that indicates this is the Azotobacter, and very high efficient bacteria. Moreover, you will never see Azotobacter in the acidic media, in acidic soil, but it is 4.5 pH of is our waste decomposer solution, but this our Azotobacter is survives. It is in crores. If you are taking the 1 ml of our waste decomposer solution, it contains crores of our Azotobacter culture. As I shown you, this Azotobacter culture present in our liquid media waste decomposer solution, it is in 1 crores. If you are taking 1 ml of our this waste decomposer solution, it is contains more than 1 crore bacteria per ml. So when it goes in the field, how it is works? Azotobacter is a nitrogen fixing bacteria. It doesn't require any help of any plants or anything. It requires only soil organic carbon. So soil organic carbon, if you have already there, it will fix the nitrogen from 10 kg nitrogen to 30 kg nitrogen, depends upon the content of organic carbon. So beauty of this our Azotobacter this waste decomposer culture is this waste decomposer culture, it helps to form the organic carbon. When we are applying this waste decomposer solution, 1000 liter per acre. So when it goes in the field, after 15 days, all the undecomposed material, it make it decomposed. And if you test the soil, organic carbon will be temporarily suited more than 0.8% or somewhere it is 1%. If it is 1%, it will be more. So it is giving the environment, better environment to the Azotobacter culture to survive and fix the nitrogen. So here in the case of Azotobacter, when you are providing this waste decomposer solution, it fixed the nitrogen minimum 30 kg per hectare. 30 kg means you can compare minimum 2 bag of urea, you will get this 30 kg. Because if you take the 2 bag of urea, you are getting only hardly 40% of the nitrogen. But some nitrogen, it leach out, operates, so you are hardly getting 15 kg of nitrogen out of 2 bag of urea in the plant. plant uptake from the soil. Similarly, here also when Azotobacter fix the nitrogen in the soil itself along with the manure itself, so if uptake is easy and it has no side effect because it is made from the atmosphere itself. This our Azotobacter culture take the nitrogen, 80% our nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, they take the nitrogen and fix in the soil. It is a natural way, it is just like factory. So these nitrogen is available to the plant, available to the soil. So when you are putting our waste decomposer solution in the any manure which is already nitrogen content is not high, but due to presence of this bacteria nitrogen content is increased, so you are getting the rich organic manure when you are using our waste decomposer. So nitrogen content will increase, and I have already shown you this also contains the azospermillium also fix the nitrogen. And this main thing, this two types of bacteria, Azotobacter and azospermillium, it is for all crops. Azotobacter particularly for the tree, for the fruits, for the vegetables, for your all the your cereal crops, you can use Azotobacter. So these never die when you are using the waste decomposer solution, because waste decomposer solution it provides the environment, it increases the organic carbon, it provides the minerals. So that minerals, organic carbon, good for the all bacteria, either it is rhizobium or it is a potash bacteria or it is your any other type of bacteria. And we have already shown this bacteria, nitrogen fixing bacteria, phosphorus bacteria and potash bacteria. So far we have shown the nitrogen fixing bacteria like Azotobacter, Azospermillium and rhizobium present in the our liquid form. So it is no need of any biofertilizer from outside, that has already we have proved. That's why repeatedly we are telling this, when you are using our waste decomposer solution, it is 1 ml contains crores of bacteria. When you are purchasing any liquid formulation or solid form your biofertilizer from outside, that contains hardly 1 crores, except few companies which are good, but other in general it is quality is not. But here you are getting 200 liter of culture that contains nitrogen, phosphorus and potash. So from outside you require, because you are going to purchase, you are hardly purchasing 1 kg or 2 kg. That cost is 300, 400 rupees. Here it is in 20 rupees, you are making this with the help of jaggery, you are making that 200 liter of your culture. Now you calculate with the cost, it is very high. In thousands and thousands, you are wasting the money from outside. So it is my humble request to all of my farmers, we have proved that this is contains our Azotobacter culture, nitrogen fixing bacteria. So no need of any biofertilizer from outside. Whatever you have Azotobacter, this Azotobacter in this waste decomposer solution, so this is enough for you, and you can make a multiply years to years. So far there is no technique which available in the market. If you take it and keep it, you cannot preserve it more than 3 months or 4 months or 1 year. So here you are for the lifelong, you are getting this culture and you are maintaining in at your home all types of bacteria, and in future we'll show you some other also what is contains. So without any suggestion, you use this and see the response in the field. That is the one reason when you are using waste decomposer solution in the field, you are getting always green, no deficiency of nitrogen is found in any type of plant.